conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Behold, handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God.
That we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
We beseech you, O Lord, pour your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion, we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Jesus Christ, our
Lord. Amen.
Lord, open our lips.
And our mouths shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Establish your hearts in holiness before our God and Father, at the coming of our Lord Jesus.
Come, let us adore him.
Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and raise a loud shout to him in psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice.
Establish your hearts in holiness before our God and Father, at the coming of our Lord Jesus.
Come, let us adore him.
Psalm 45. My heart is stirring with a noble song. Let me recite without fashion for the king. My tongue shall be the pen of a skilled writer.
You are the fairest of men. Grace flows from your lips, because God has blessed you forever.
Strap your sword upon your thigh, mighty warrior. In your pride and your majesty,
ride out and conquer to the cause of truth, and for the sake of justice.
Your right hand will show you marvelous things. Your arrows are very sharp, O mighty warrior.
Peoples are falling at your feet, and the king's enemies are losing heart.
The throne of God endures forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of your kingdom. You love righteousness and hate iniquity.
Therefore God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness above your fellows.
All your garments are fragrant from myrrh, aloes, and cassia. And the music of strings from ivory palaces makes you glad.
King's daughters stand among the ladies of court. On your right hand is the queen, adorned with the gold of Ophir.
Hear, O daughter, consider and listen closely. Forget your people and your father's house.
The king will have pleasure in your beauty. He is your master, therefore do him honor.
People of Tyre, hear the gift. The rich among the people seek your favor.
All glorious is the princess Asciendus. Her gown is cloth of gold.
An embroidered apparel she has brought to the king. After her the bridesmaids follow in procession.
With joy and gladness they are brought, and enter into the palace of the king.
In place of fathers, O king, you shall have sons. You shall make them princes over all the earth.
I will make your name to be remembered from one generation to another. Therefore, nations will praise you forever and ever.
Glory to the Father,
and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
Prophet Zechariah, second chapter, beginning with the first verse. I looked up and saw a man with a measuring line in his hand. Vernon asked, "Where are you going?" He answered, "To measure Jerusalem, to see what is its width and what is its length." Then the angel who talked with me came forward, and another angel came forward to meet him and said to him, "Run, say to that young man, Jerusalem shall be inhabited like villages without walls, because of the multitude of people and animals in it. For I will be a wall of fire all around it, says the Lord, and I will be the glory within it. Up, up, flee from the land of the north, says the Lord, for I have spread you abroad like the four winds of heaven, says the Lord. Up, escape to Zion, you that live with daughter Babylon. For thus says the Lord of hosts, after his glory sent me, regarding the nations that plundered you. Truly, one who touches you touches the apple of my eye. See now, I am going to raise my hand against them, and they shall become plunder for their own slaves. Then you will know that the Lord of hosts has sent me. Sing and rejoice, O daughter Zion, for lo, I will come and dwell in your midst, says the Lord. Many nations shall join themselves to the Lord on that day, and you shall be my people, and I will dwell in your midst. And you shall know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. The Lord will inherit Judah as his portion in the Holy Land, and will again choose Jerusalem. Be silent, all people, before the Lord. He has roused himself from his holy dwelling." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A song of God's herald. Go up to a high mountain.
Herald of good tidings to Zion. Lift up your voice with strength.
Herald
good tidings to Jerusalem. Lift up your voice, fear not. Say to the cities of Judah, behold your God. See the Lord God coming with power, coming to rule with his mighty arm.
He brings his reward for the people of God, the recompense for those who are saved. God will feed his flock like a shepherd, and gather the lambs in his arms.
He will hold them to his breast, and gently lead those that are with young.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Gospel of Matthew, 24th chapter, beginning in the 32nd verse. Jesus said to his disciples, "From the fig tree learn this lesson. As soon as its branches become tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see all these things, you know that he is near at the very gates. Truly I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day now no one knows, neither the angels of heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. For as the days of Noah, so will be the coming of the Son of Man. For as in those days before the flood they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day Noah entered the ark, and they knew nothing until the flood came and swept them all away. So too will be the coming of the Son of Man. Then two will be in the field, one will be taken and one will be left. Two women will be grinding meal together, one will be taken and one will be left. Keep awake, therefore, for you do not know on what day your Lord is coming. But understand this, if the owner of the house had known in what part of the night the thief was coming, he would have stayed awake and would not have let his house be broken into. Therefore you also must be ready. The Son of Man is coming at an unexpected hour." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A song of the Spirit. Behold, I am coming soon, says the Lord, and bringing my reward with me,
to give to everyone according to their deeds.
I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end.
Blessed are those who do God's commandments, that they may have the right to the tree of life, and may enter into the city through the gates.
I, Jesus, have sent my angel to you, with this testimony for all the churches.
I am the root and the offspring of David.
I am the bright morning star.
Come, said the Spirit and the Bride.
Come, let each hear a reply.
Come forward, you who are thirsty.
Let those who desire take water of life as a gift. To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb, be blessing and honour and glory and might, forever and ever.
Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary.
He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread.
Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance.
Govern and uphold them now and always.
Day by day we bless you.
We praise your name forever.
Lord, keep us from all sin today.
Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust in you.
In you, Lord, is our hope.
We shall never hope in vain.
Stir up your power, Lord, with great might come among us. And because we are sorely hindered by our sins, let your bountiful grace and mercy speedily help and deliver us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honour and glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and put on the armour of light. Now in the time of this mortal life, in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us with great humility, that in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the living and the dead, we may rise to the light and immortal. Through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
O God, the King eternal, whose light divides the day from the night, and turns the shadow of death into the morning, drive far from us all wrong desires, incline our hearts to keep your law, and guide our feet into the way of peace, that having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you as eternal life and to serve you with perfect freedom, defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting your defence, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time at one accord to make our common supplication to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions that may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all evermore.
Amen.